Divine Truth Assistance Group. These group assistance sessions are about putting principles of divine truth into action. This discussion is part of the 2014 Australia Group 1 series. Cornelius discusses homework on recognizing addictions in relationships, filmed on the 17th of July 2014 in Monkerai, New South Wales, Australia.
Is it still there? It is still there. Oh, I'm not used to the still stick. Okay, so we're doing recognizing addictions. We did that the other day with you guys and I gave you some homework. Do you remember the first question I wrote for you? I'll write it up on the board very quickly. It was to write down every time we feel compelled. Compelled, in a frenzy. Well, you know what they are. We're talking about this section of the diagram, by the way, too. The compulsions, when we start to act on them, act on our compulsions. So what'd you come up with? Deidre?
Lack of money, like finance.
So that triggers you?
Yeah, big time.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Next, anybody? Yeah, Joy and anybody else on this side? Yourself? Can't remember your name. Karen.
I focused on the environment here and I actually wrote down every interaction I had with another person and realised in every one of those interactions I was feeling a compulsion.
To try and get something met,
yes,
all the time?
Yes. Uh-huh.
Yep. Karen?
Just whenever there's like an awkward silence, I just felt compelled to speak and say something.
Because you feel awkward,
yeah,
inside yourself?
Yep.
Uh-huh. Barb?
When I don't feel as if I'm in control myself.
Uh-huh. So you want to try and claw for something, try,
yep,
and make yourself feel in control again?
Yep, yep.
Uh-huh. Down the back there, Cecily.
I recognise that I have compulsions. In the past, I've had a lot of compulsions around sex,
uh-huh,
and I'm currently experiencing my compulsions around food, especially here.
Ah, so you can just identify a few uncomfortable areas where you just got to go and try and get something to make it feel comfortable. Yep. Fab? Anybody else over this side too? Or keep running it around? Matt?
I found that it's all the time nearly. Like every area. It's like sex, food, people, addiction, needs, wants. And it was like a...
Yeah, your whole life is just built around, isn't,
yeah,
it?
Yeah, I didn't notice when I'm not actually in addiction.
And that's why our lives feel frenetic and frenzied all the time and busy. To keep constantly trying to get those addictions met. So we've got that pretty sort of... Oh, Matt, I'll just ask you now, then you got the mic, or yours?
Oh, yeah. Sort of wanting some kind of sexual interaction.
Yeah, same as Cecily.
Yeah, same as Cecily. And just like wanting people to pay attention to me and give me time and approval and just like when I'm in an interaction with someone or there's an opportunity for an interaction with someone, like what's pulling me to do that?
So it's that real just clawing, just trying to drag, just trying to get desperation almost to get the feeling,
yeah,
felt all the time. So you guys are pretty good at identifying that. Like you can recognise that a little bit more in your life, intellectually at the moment more so. You start to see what's going on and know that compulsion feeling. It's pretty much like Fab was saying, it's just about with everything. Yeah. So how about your next question? Did you get to that one? So you got that one pretty fast. Actually, with that first one, it's the easiest one for you guys to see. But it's like the tip of the iceberg. It's the 10% you're seeing. It's the rest of them you're having the most amount of problems with, and we'll go through those now. So the second question was... I might just say them, save me writing them. Write down what you do when, one, you satisfy your addiction. So we're on this side of the diagram, and we want to get our addiction met. What do we do? Peter? And man, I'm bad with names today. Teresa, yeah.
Often I feel like I've earned it. Uh-huh. I deserve it.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, things like TV or food or something like that, it's like I've worked really hard. So this is like
my... I deserve it.
This is my pay for what I've just done.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yep, you've given out. Now you've got to get something back. Uh-huh. Teresa?
I find that it helps me just numb out and not feel anything. For things like going on to checking emails or Facebook, it just helps me just... zone out, basically.
So do you get it through an addiction that way?
Yeah, so going from Facebook.
It makes you feel, it almost doesn't make you feel anything.
Hmm.
Yeah, I guess so, yeah. Yep. Die? Yeah, it helps you avoid the feelings you just don't want to feel.
Yeah. If I don't get it one way, I'm searching for another way. I can get it met and I can feel that this sort of demanding sort of part of me like wants to really try and push to get it met, and then just feel how, you know, how I keep feeling about that.
So the how do you
okay,
sorry, what was that one again?
No, I guess when my addiction doesn't get met in the first place,
just when we get it met,
when it's met, sorry.
Yeah, that's okay. What I thought. I wasn't quite with you on that one. Yeah.
Okay.
We'll go to that one next. Barb? So what's the feeling of satisfying the compulsion?
I'm not sure if I got this right either, but one of my first ones was wanting to be heard. So the answer to this question was just to speak louder if I'm not heard.
And so what do you feel when that happens? How does it feel?
Well, my addiction's being met if I speak louder, because usually I'm then heard.
Mm-hmm.
So it's still, it's not a willingness to feel. It's just speaking louder, so I am heard.
Yeah,
so therefore,
everybody else.
So therefore, the compulsion's met.
And the good thing about identifying these is we're going to notice that they're all very selfish. So you want to be heard over everybody else. No one else is important. I'm the most important.
Mm.
Yeah. Mm. Dave, and over side here. Just keep your hands up so the mic runners can see you where you are.
Sometimes it's like the compulsion is just automatic out of fear, and then I don't feel good afterwards. I just kind of feel like I've satisfied a demand right at that time and ready for the next one to come along, sort of thing.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I kind of justify it by saying, oh, well, you know, that frenzied feeling really wasn't nice and now I feel better, so I was right in...
justified.
In meeting it, yeah. So I justify the fact that I gave in by saying, well, it wasn't nice what I felt before.
So you just keep getting more, wanting more?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Matt and Denise?
Yeah, kind of a little bit similar to Joanne. Like I try and like tell myself that it's not so bad what I'm doing.
Yeah.
I want to, because like, I don't feel so good about it sometimes after I get an addiction med, but then I'm like, well, trying to convince myself, well, I didn't involve that many people, or I didn't...
So trying to justify and minimise it.
Yeah, justify and minimise it, yeah.
Denise?
I'll find that I'll feel some sort of happiness.
Uh-huh.
So falsely.
Yep. Die. And everybody else? Down the front, yeah. Go die.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, no, I can feel how I feel like really like powerful and smug and like clever sometimes, uh-huh. that I've got what I want, but there's also that yucky feeling of having taken from somebody else to get that.
Remember, we're quite selfish, so how often do we really feel those feelings? Because we keep going back and getting more, don't we? Yeah.
A lot of my addictions confirm for me that I'm a good girl.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a nice girl.
Yep. No matter what I've got to do. Al? And Neil just behind you there, Pete. Paul?
A lot of times I just blow it off and say, oh, well, we've all got our vices. We're just part of the human family.
So once again, just minimising it.
Just minimising it, that it feels good in that moment. Find some excuse.
Mm-hmm. It's pretty common, isn't it? Neil, yep.
I feel validated.
Just hold the mic.
Oh, right, like that. I feel validated and significant and worthy, all that. But yes. It's the wrong way of achieving it.
Yeah, well, that's what addiction's a lot about. Yes. It's just trying to find our worth through them, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. So, anybody else? Raj and... I'm not good with names today, sorry. You know who you are, so put your hand up. Yeah, thanks. Raj.
For me, it's very much about being in the material world and the results orientated.
Just focused on getting the material things met?
And continuously being rewarded by having achieved something. It's like a endless train.
So you feel addiction is a good thing for you that you keep on getting?
Oh, I don't think it's a good thing, but I can't get off the rail.
Beg your pardon?
I can't get off the rail.
Can't get off the rail, yeah. Just the compulsion keeps coming back around. You need more and more of it.
Yeah, and the rewards come up. Oh, good job, well done. That looks
that's
nice.
That's what it feels like. I'm getting rewarded.
One. Yeah, and then there's another one, and there's another one, mm-hmm. another one.
Sheridan, I remember your name now.
Sometimes I felt disappointed in myself, but relieved that I'd let myself do it.
So there's a guilt, but I still want more?
Yes.
Like chocolate?
Coffee.
Coffee, yeah. Yeah. And the emotional addictions too, like the same sort of thing. Yeah. Any more? Yeah, Christiana?
That I feel right, which can translate to being righteous.
Just justified in it. Yeah. Just pass it two rows back there. Yeah.
A lot of mine are related to being made to feel special.
Mm-hmm. There's a lot of these, isn't there? There's like Fab was saying, there's so many things you can, like, we're compulsed to do just to try and get our good feelings met. So we don't want to feel the bad ones. The trouble is when we're trying to get them met, like a lot of us were just noticing then, and we're just so focused on straight ahead of got to get that feeling met, got to get that feeling met. And I don't care how, I don't care why, I just got to get it met. And we never look at what's happening around and how we're getting it met, and never actually look in the rearview mirror and look back and see the damage we've done. We don't want it, we're not clocking it. A lot of you guys I can notice too, not clocking the feeling of it. You can say the words, but it's just, there's not a feeling. That you're actually feeling the hurt, like the sin in the addiction, the damage it's causing yourself and others. And you need to get to that point. You're going to need to get to that point. No, yeah, I want to keep getting my addictions met, but I don't care. It's that feeling, I don't care. And that's the one that's damaging the most. You need to start caring. Unfortunately, when you want your addictions, love is the last thing you're thinking about. You need to have that as the first one. Try and put the addiction aside, the compulsion aside, and feel about love. So we'll get on to question number two in that section. When the compulsion is not satisfied, what's it like? Fab? And Paul? Yeah.
Desireless. Like I feel like I've got no desire for weeks. You know, like my passion for life just disappears. I guess numb, I could probably say.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Paul?
Sort of unaware what's going on, and a fear and a panic and a terror, like not mm-hmm. knowing why I feel this, but yeah.
And joy? And yeah. Deidre. So go, Joy.
Yeah, it's the first time I've really felt how I feel in that situation, and I was just... desperate terror of not knowing what to do. All I wanted to do was escape, and I realised that's the feeling that I don't want to feel, and that's what drives the whole cycle because I don't want to go there.
So you go back and find another addiction because that gets you out of that terrible
feeling?
That's
the temptation, yeah. But mm-hmm. thanks for the exercise, because I actually answered one of them differently and actually looked at what I did in every interaction and observed how I interacted with men and how I interacted with women and what I was trying to get out of them. And it's the first time I've really seen, because I've never ever thought before of the damage that I'm doing to somebody else, to make myself feel more superior and to make me feel good. Thank you.
Cool. Deidre and yourself up the back. What's your name? You can tell me when the mic comes on, so I remember it if I can.
I get angry.
Angry? Yeah. It's a common reaction. Yeah. Yourself, and Dave?
Yeah, my name's Joanne.
Hi, Joanne, thanks.
And that's okay. Sometimes it depends on what the addiction was, but sometimes I actually feel relieved, like something saved me from myself.
When it's not getting met?
When it's not getting met.
Oh, I don't agree with that one.
Oh, well, and other times I think, oh, well, I didn't deserve it anyway, kind of thing.
Trying to deny?
Yeah. Yeah. So when I feel it, I also feel guilty.
That's more like it now.
Yeah. So it's, those guilt-based things. Yeah.
No, I don't agree with that one either. You don't often feel guilty at all.
All right.
Yeah. I have to look at that one again a bit more honestly, I feel.
Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Who did I go to over here? Oh, sorry, Dave. Thanks.
Yeah. How's it going? I generally notice that I'd feel quite confused in the interaction, and then afterwards I'd feel like kind of like sort of either like hurt or attacked or maybe like a bit rejected. But generally it's the confusion at first. I'm like, what's going on there? Something doesn't seem right. Just because it's so automatic, I guess, normally.
There's a little battle going on, like something's not right.
Yeah, well, I don't know, just... Yeah, like I said, like just because it's so normal, the interaction, just expect that sort of response whenever just engaging with somebody.
Sort of in...
And then it's just like I feel something go out and just coming straight back at me, like it's my own feeling coming back up. I'm just like, what?
So like indignant, like, come on, like what's going on? Meet it.
I'm a bit dumbfounded at what's going on. Like that's just so unusual for me, I guess.
Yeah. Who else we got? Helga and... Who haven't we had over here? It's two rows back to you.
Depending on the situation, I feel irritated, unhappy, edgy, antsy, angry, treated unfairly, and very restless most of the time. Mm-hmm. And always happily, totally oblivious to the sin committed by blaming everyone and anything else but myself.
Yep, I'd agree with the first half of that. And the second half, I don't think so. I don't feel many people get to that as well, that they don't feel that you feel like you're committed to sin, because we're often straight back into the same thing again. We don't often want to see that part of it. We just want to have the addiction met again.
Yeah. Well, I said I'm totally oblivious.
What was the last things you said, though?
I said totally oblivious to the sin committed.
Oh, sorry. Okay, yeah. I thought there was one word in there you said and I didn't think that matched somewhere. Doesn't matter. We'll keep moving on.
Totally
Dave?
Oblivious.
Oh, sorry,
I suppress heaps and heaps and heaps, and when I do actually notice that it's coming through, like this kind of need to do this, and it doesn't get met, I just feel a build-up of really negative energy, and then I just go straight into projecting or some rage might come out. I've tried last night just to walk out and go up the road and feel some stuff, and
Mm-hmm. It's a common reaction. Where are we up to? Mel and this side. Bob? Mel?
I feel anger, but it's more of a rage, but it's real justified rage. It's
often a common feeling too.
It's more than irritated. It's just like from 0 to 100, like this is not my fault. Like
Blame.
Yeah, a total blame, but not only blame, attack.
To try and get it back, clawing desperately.
To get it back, but also, this is probably a bit beyond, which I'm not doing, the fear, avoiding the fear, but, to get it back, claw it back.
Yeah. Barb?
When mine's not met, in that moment, the initial thing is I get more forceful.
Until it's met.
Yeah, end up trying sneaky ways and trying a different tact.
You name it, man.
Manipulating, coercion.
I'm an expert.
Yeah, it's not good.
it's not now.
It feels like you got some pride in that.
Up till, yes, definitely. Mm. I get my own way in the end by all of the little tactics that I've learnt to use, and they're very unloving and inconsiderate to everybody else.
No, I think you think they're pretty good. I think you've got a skill.
I still do, because I haven't really felt them. Yeah. Yeah.
That's why we try and tell ourselves, honestly, that we feel like we think things, we've identified it, we feel it's bad and stuff like that, but honestly, we really want it. We're not telling ourselves the truth about that. Yes. We become quite skillful at getting what we want and manipulating people, hurting people to get what we want. And we find ways, we know ways. We even manipulate their own emotions. We know their weak spots, their spots that we can actually manipulate so nicely that we'll get what we want.
Yeah, so at least I've identified it, and, you know, it's up to me to feel about the grief behind me doing all of that.
And why you're doing it
and
for.
And why I'm doing it.
And why you want to continue doing it, though, too.
And I still do continue it every minute. Mm. Yes. Yeah. Thanks, Corny.
All right. Any more? Haven't we had Celia? Or Cecilia? I'm not sure which one.
it's Cecilia.
So, thanks.
When my addiction is not getting mad, usually I feel very angry, restless, and super uncomfortable until I get it mad.
Yeah, it feels like that, doesn't it?
Yeah. And also I notice myself sometimes I go into self-punishment, like I blame myself.
To try and, yeah. It happens quite often too. Yeah. Well, a lot of the times that's not true. A lot of times you end up blaming the other person.
Also.
So often we don't want to blame ourselves. Yeah, we get quite grumpy at them.
Yeah.
Alvin and Denise.
Enraged, and even if I feel some of it, I don't get to all of it, and then I feel, but I'm still right.
Yeah, I feel quite justified
in
it.
And then I cry about how terrible it is that I'm still right and no one's recognised it.
I reckon you're crying because you haven't got it met.
Yeah, maybe this.
Yeah, see, we've got to be honest. Like we're awesome at bullshitting ourselves. We've become, like we're saying, we've become experts at doing manipulating people. We've really become, like, we've perfected at just bullshitting ourselves, not telling ourselves the truth of what we're really doing, and that what we're really doing is really harming persons. We try and tell ourselves, "Oh, it's okay. It just doesn't really matter. Everybody's in addictions, and he's getting something out of it. I'm getting something out of it." We try and just play it off as something nice and fluffy. We just haven't come to the point yet that it's actually so damaging, incredibly damaging. We all complain about the world, the condition it's in, but we're creating it. We don't see it. We're just not clocking it, that we're creating it. Yet we want to complain about it. Yet we want to stay in our addictions. We want them so bad. You've got to come to that realization. We want them. We don't want to see the damage it's doing. We don't get to these... Oh, it feels sleazy, it feels horrible. We're not even there, it's just words. We want them. And at least come to the truth. Nothing's going to change unless you come to your own personal truth. Got to start to get to that point. Know how much you want your addiction. It's the only way you're ever going to get out of it, is recognizing how much you want it. It'll help you with the feeling that's creating it. So start getting honest, really honest. We'll go to question number 3, which was, what is frustrating about my relationship with God? Vanessa? And Di, did you have your hand up? Yeah.
He just won't give me what I want.
Exactly.
You're like, I've got all these compulsions and addictions, and he just won't meet any of them.
Yep. God doesn't do that. That's why it's frustrating. Who do we have? Di, yep.
Yeah, I was going to say something similar. I just can't get what I want from God. I can't get love from God when I want it. Just nothing, no answer at all. Really gives me the shits.
Frustrating.
Absolutely.
Yep. Have this side, Joy, and another one, Pete, behind you there. And
yeah, very similar. God's not there for me and God doesn't hear me. And I make that mean
that God doesn't care about me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yep, true. That's, well, it's not true, but that's where we go. Yep.
I feel deceived, lied to, and sort of taken from me. God's been taken from me. And another big one for me is, like, I feel God should protect me and look after me.
Yeah, so putting a lot of heat on God, aren't we? Like, a lot of look after me all the time. Yeah, I don't want to do anything, but look after me.
Especially, like, if I'm a good guy, a good boy, then justify God's just automatically going to just look after me too. Uh-huh. So, yeah.
Therese and Diane then, and where we go to from here? Felix and Rachel. I'm getting good names. Okay, who do I say now? Therese, all right, yeah.
He won't answer me, so I'm frustrated mm-hmm. about that. And I can't see him, so I don't know if he's real.
Mm-hmm.
And I just hope he does. And he's made it really hard for me.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm not getting the pat on the back.
I'm not agreeing, I'm just saying yes, yeah. I'm listening to your answers.
And, I'm not getting the pat on the back that I want.
Mm-hmm. And who do we have over here? Felix.
Just seems kind of pointless to even engage a relation with God. Like, I try a bit and then it's like, seems something too far off in the future, if it's even possible.
So there's nothing tangible you can feel a relationship or response with, you feel?
Yeah.
Or something?
Yeah. Seems very, to me it feels one way, I suppose.
Mm.
Yeah. And, pointless.
Uh-huh. And we have one more over here somewhere? Yeah, Dane?
God won't take my pain away.
Mm-hmm. That's a big one, isn't it? I feel frustrated about that. Yep. And just back to Helga. Rachel?
Yeah, mine's similar to that, that I have to do all this work just to be happy, just to feel genuinely happy.
So it's a chore?
Yeah, and it's somebody else, immediately it's somebody else put this in me. Then I recognise I created a lot of it, but that it's hard work.
Just want God to give it to me, basically, and it's not happening.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And good. Up the back there to Wayne. Helga, yep. Yes.
That I don't really have one, but I think I do.
Oh, what's that?
A relationship with God. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And that I do really not believe it's possible to have one.
Mm-hmm. These are all common feelings. Wayne, yep.
Yeah, nothing. I haven't really tried.
Beg your pardon?
Nothing frustrates me because I haven't really tried.
What's one point, isn't it? Yeah. And Sheridan?
Mine's similar, I think, that I just don't want one with God. Like, regardless of what I've heard, I don't want a relationship with God. And I find that really frustrating from what I've heard.
So God's like all my other relationships. Is that what you're saying? And they're all hurtful, painful?
It seems like there's so many wonderful things or there's so much potential there. And I just go, no, I don't want it.
So you don't want to be happy?
No, that's what I think, because I don't believe there's possible to be happy.
So there's no faith?
No faith.
So I'll just wind it up with this question too. There's lots of, what's a feeling? Basically, what we're saying is we want God to meet my addictions. I want God to come to me. I don't want to put any effort in. I want God to come and fix everything for me. I don't want to see the system that God's already created for me to help me decide to want to fix myself or engage in it myself. I don't want to see any of my pain. I just trust so instinctively in this addiction system that I even want God to come and come over to my side in the addiction system. I don't want to step over to God's side. There's no desire. I'm not using my will in that way. I'm telling God to come to me and come and fix me up, come and make me feel happy. It's just the same cycle, trying to involve God in it, and God's not going to take any part in that. But we still want that from God, and we get frustrated with God. The trouble is the beauty of it with God is it's a feeling relationship, it's a heart relationship, and that's what love is. Love, you can't think love, you can't measure love like with a gauge, or we can't weigh it, it's a feeling. And so you're gonna, this system's going to prevent you from feeling. It's going to stop your feeling. It shuts down all your feelings. So you can't ever connect with God. So that's why it's so frustrating. You're trying to connect with God when you don't want to open up your own feelings. You don't want to know yourself. That's why it's going to be constantly frustrating until something changes in yourself. And you're in charge of that, not God. So it's just something to ponder for you guys, for everybody, me, everybody. Just basically wanting God to do it for us, wanting God to do all the work. We've got to start using our will in a direction that's going to actually have us do the work, and us create the change and meet God. I might wind up there and we'll get on to the, do you want to have any say in any of those, a few of those questions or anything? Nope. Okay. We'll wind up and we'll get on to the personal truth sessions. Thanks a lot for your input on your homework there too. And thanks. Bye.